determine the domain and range, use interval notation. Recall the domain is the set of all inputs, which are often the x values, and the range is the set of all outputs, which are often the y values. For the first graph, we will assume this piece on the left continues. And for the second graph, we'll assume the piece on the left and the piece on the right also continue. To determine the domain, we analyze the graph from left to right or along the x-axis. Notice the graph continues to the left indefinitely, and therefore we can say the domain approaches negative infinity. Notice there is a break in the graph at x equals negative 4, but because of this closed point, negative 4, comma, negative 5, the function is defined at x equals negative 4, and negative 4 is in the domain. Continuing to the rightmost point is where x equals 0. Because we only have an open point at x equals 0, 0 is not in the domain, we make an open point. This indicates the domain is the open interval from a negative infinity to 0. Recall the parenthesis to the right of 0 indicates 0 is not in the interval, and we always use parentheses for plus or minus infinity. To determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically or along the y-axis. The lowest point on the graph is this point here where y equals negative 5. Negative 5 is in the range. From here, the graph continues upward until the y value of 3. Because we only have an open point at y equals 3, 3 is not in the range. We make an open point. Then the graph jumps up to where y equals 8, but because we only have an open point at y equals 8, 8 is not in the range. And then from here the graph continues upward, and y approaches infinity. This indicates the range is the interval from negative 5 to 3, closed on negative 5, open on 3, union, the open interval from 8 to infinity. And again, the square bracket indicates negative 5 is in the interval, and the parenthesis indicates 3 is not in the interval. And now let's look at our second example. Starting with the domain, we analyze the graph from left to right. We can see the graph continues to the left indefinitely, and therefore x approaches negative infinity. And then moving to the right, we do have a break in the graph at x equals 0, but we do have a closed point 0, comma 3 here, which indicates the function is defined at x equals 0. X equals 0 is in the domain. The graph continues to the right. At x equals 4, we have another break in the graph. Notice both points are open, and therefore the function is not defined at x equals 4. 4 is not in the domain. We make an open point. And then the graph continues to the right, and x approaches infinity. This indicates the domain is the open interval from negative infinity to 4. Union, the open interval from 4 to infinity. And now we'll analyze the graph vertically to determine the range. We need to be careful when analyzing the graph vertically. It may appear as if this open point is the lowest point on the graph, but again, we're assuming this piece on the right continues downward, and therefore the range is going to approach negative infinity. And then continuing upward, at y equals 0, we have a couple open points, but y equals 0 is in the range because of the closed point on this piece of the graph, and therefore the range continues upward, and the function takes on all the y values as y increases and approaches infinity. This indicates the range is all real numbers, which we indicate using interval notation as the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. I hope you found this helpful.